Here are three real-world examples of how messy this can be. In the US, major ports and rail yards become choked not only by physical congestion, but also by missing handoff events. You know, the whole system was not built for this. Freight delays hammer the US. The missing or lagging data compounded delay after delay. In Europe, for example, we can see regularly global shipping realignments, rerouting of vessels, changing trade flows. These can be triggered, you know, to absorb capacity around issues in ports like Spain or in Morocco. But these overloaded terminals do result in waits and backlogs. But more than that, crucially, the planning systems for many manufacturers, they never update their inbound arrival times in real time. Also consider that globally, more than 350 container ships capable of carrying nearly 2.4 million TEUs, 20-foot equivalents, were waiting off ports at one stage. Even if the physical ship sits, the data about the delay often doesn't reach downstream parties until much later. Ships waiting, terminals waiting, warehouse waiting. Data waits too. So what's the effect? Your inventory tracking shows good in transit, when in fact they're stalled at anchor. Your planners schedule production based on expected arrival that the system doesn't know is already delayed. Your customers get promised a delivery date while you're still waiting for the data that confirms the goods even left the port. In global supply chains, one missing event can mean tens of thousands of misaligned actions. This is the quiet chaos between ship and shore, the place where control is lost and reactivity begins. In the next section, we'll see what that chaos looks like in practice and why the consequences ripple much beyond the port gate.